It's a special night for the sophomores as the Eastern Florida State College women's basketball team takes on Palm Beach State College. Live from Titan Fieldhouse on the Melbourne campus, it's the Titans and the Panthers, and it is next. It is a night in which we will say so long to the two sophomores on the Titans roster. Good evening and welcome, everybody. Alongside the host of Inside Titans Sports, Eric Kohler, I'm Jeff Radcliffe. Thank you so very much for joining us for Titans basketball here on WEFS-TV. Very simple. We say so long to the two sophomores on the roster, as I already said. Titans, winners of two of three. They've been playing well, but they're up against it tonight against the number 12 team in the country, a team that's won 15 in a row in Palm Beach.
Well, Palm Beach State, I'll tell you what, in a show of some celebration right here in the court, just a great ball team. They're 10-0 in conference. They wrapped up the conference, and you can see just a great respect right there, obviously, with Jim Grimes passing over just under a month ago. And Palm Beach State, not only do they come in as a powerhouse, but just showing some great respect right now. And this is what it's all about, Jeff.
Yeah, T-shirt exchange at midcourt is the entire Southern Conference really paying its respects and homage to Coach Grimes. It's been a wonderful thing to see out of a tragic event.
Right. I mean, you can't bring Coach Grimes back, but on Inside Titan Sports, so we had the whole women's team on a great segment, really special segment to come on, to have all the players be like, and now we got disciples. The Jim Grimes energy, everything he did for the community is for his family. It's great to see he planted those seeds doing things paying forward.
Will be Palm Beach State and Eastern Florida. Again, two of the hottest teams in the league here as we set this up. Palm Beach, we already alluded to it. They've got six players on the roster that transferred in. They are sophomore-based team versus the freshman-based team from Eastern Florida State College as they get set for their paying respects to Jim Grimes. Doing that one right now. But again, a very young team, very impressionable team. And this will be the last time on the home floor, which will have a lot of meaning for them.
Well, and again, you know, Palm Beach State comes in, as you said, big Division I players. They have nine sophomores they're going to celebrate on their sophomore celebration. We have two. So the depth is really a big issue for Eastern Florida. But the way they played, you said before, the last two out of three games, they played with a lot of heart. And being sophomore day, it's going to be a very highly emotional game. Obviously, they'll honor them thereafter, the game at the conclusion. But again, you never know. Palm Beach State, great team. But the biggest thing, they've wrapped it up. Maybe they stubbed their toe against Eastern Florida.
Pause now for our national anthem.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Jay DeBello with our national anthem as we get set for the Panthers and Titans here on WEFS. And the big three, the trifecta, you can call it all. You've got the three sophomores. Alexis Jean really leading things as far as scoring fourth in the state.
Yeah, Alexis Jean, pretty special, obviously, just under 10 rebounds a game, but almost 20 points per game as well. But you got to talk about Shakoya Edwards and Jonica Garvin. They really clicked together. That's the biggest thing for Alexis Jean. So watch out. She's the heart of that big three, as coach says, for Palm Beach State.
On the other side, one of the two sophomores in the starting lineup tonight, Trudy Walker, the double-double machine out of Fort Pierce Westwood.
Yeah, Trudy, she's special. You know, congratulations to Trudy. Everything they've gone through of losing coach and to become like an outspoken leader, just so special. And to be the NJCAA Region 8 Player of the Week, I'm really proud of Trudy Walker. And it'd be great if she could go out with a bang in front of the hometown team.
Panthers and Titans being introduced to the crowd here at the Titan Fieldhouse. We'll introduce you to them as well. Shakoya Edwards, Jonica Garvin, Alexis Jean, the big three that Eric just alluded to. Filling out that starting lineup will be Crystal Williams and Khadijah Huggins. For Eastern Florida, the standard five, except for Taylor Smith, who's had a good run right now. The other sophomore starting down low alongside Trudy Walker.
And I think it's a great touch. Obviously, at the NJCAA level, you're basically bringing in your sophomores the last time you'll be on the floor. But congratulations to Taylor Smith. Hope she has a good game as well.
Two coaches in this one. Eastern Florida State College going to be led by Stephanie Schaefer and Gabrielle Duran, the interim head coaches, and Chris Rufo on the other side in her ninth season, three-time coach of the year. The officials, David Kramer, Tony Brackens, and Sam Crawford.
I'm excited for this energy, though. I think it's great. There's Coach Rufo right there. She's a nine season with Palm Beach State. She's created a winning program. She's done a great job down there, and it's talked to her before the game. She said it's not a hard sell to get kids to come back and play in Palm Beach, Florida. So she's excited, but she's worried about this. She said she didn't see as great of energy of the practice this week, so maybe this is an opportunity for the Titans to maybe catch them off guard tonight.
They have already clinched the conference championship. They are undefeated in conference play, 10-0 coming in with two games to play. So a playoff spot already in hand, a conference championship in hand. Any chance, Eric Kohler, do they take the foot off the gas pedal tonight?
Well, you never know. I mean, obviously, Palm Beach State is 10-0 in conference for a reason. They've outscored their opponents by 25 points in conference. The biggest thing is Eastern Florida has to put together a 40-minute game, a complete game, and they did that against Indian River. See if they can parlay it in against Palm Beach State.
Panthers a much deeper team, 21-2 overall, 15-game winning streak. Eastern Florida's won 2 of 3. And it will be Victoria Morales to jump in the middle with Alexis Jean, 6'1 sophomore out of Port St. Lucie, so not too far from where she played her high school ball. The tip is going to be controlled by Shakoya Edwards.
Yeah, Shakoya, Coach Rufo said as Shakoya goes, so does Palm Beach State. So keep a lookout for number one for Palm Beach State in the gold and green.
Caitlin Smith on the move here. Setting up shot for Eastern Florida. Mariah Bates, top of the key. Crystal Williams guarding her. And turned over, Edwards came up with it. Southern Miss transfer on the move.
Got to take care of the basketball. You can't turn the ball over against a high-scoring machine like Palm Beach State.
Three on the way. Alexis Jean's first shot off the mark. Eastern Florida the rebound, no score. Just underway first quarter.
Yeah, I like the energy so far for the Titans. Obviously play real well here in Titan Fieldhouse. But this is a great opportunity for these sophomores to go out with a bang against a big team like Palm Beach State.
And Eastern Florida, a team very freshman-driven, and there's a turnover to start things off. The pull-up on the way. Bates tipping up the rebound and tipping it in. So first bucket
gonna give it goes to Crystal Williams.
Williams, yep.
Well, that was just kind of unlucky right there for the Titans to get the tip. The ball was live. It goes down for Palm Beach State.
Bates will try to score it under her own basket this time, and she'll be sent out of bounds.
That's a good denial down low by Jonica Garvin, number 21. Good look there. That young lady is going to Mississippi State in the SEC. That is saying a lot when a young lady's moving on to the SEC.
She came to the Panthers from Auburn, so yeah. A tour of the SEC.
How about that?
It's out of play. Eastern Florida will be relegated to playing defensive again there. Just underway, down a bucket.
Yeah, I mean, the biggest thing with the Titans, they got to keep that energy up, but they don't have as deep of a bench as Palm Beach State, so they really have to conserve that energy to play the full 40.
Edwards running the point, 7.6 assists per game. That would lead the state by two, but she had not played 60% of the team's game, so she doesn't get that doesn't get that call.
Great defense down low by Trudy Walker. She said her key is on the show last week just to stay low to get that inside position. Good board.
Averaging 12.8. And Brooklyn Cruz already in the game, who had her career high in that last game against Indian River, 16 points. And she was a spark.
Was a spark. And had been without the injuries right there, Brooklyn would be a bigger part of this team. Crystal Williams picks up her first for Palm Beach.
Taylor Smith to inbound. And trying to force it into Walker, turned over. Garvin, they'll push numbers underneath. And the shot is altered just enough. Cruz comes away with it for Eastern Florida, runs into a trap.
Gotta take care of the basketball.
Luckily, Palm Beach has not been making their shots.
Yeah, you're right on that. But good defense down low to kind of force them into making kind of some different moves under the basket. So kudos to the defense for the Titans, but still, you can't turn the ball over, especially at home.
And talked about Edwards, who's inbounding. Not enough games to qualify for the assist title, but running away with it. 7.6 dimes a game at the top of the key right now. Crystal Williams. Working it around the perimeter, good defense by the Titans. And a foul on Smith.
That's take down it out low. Yeah, I mean, Taylor Smith right there tried to hold position, but Palm Beach State backs him down. Good call by the referee. Taylor's got to get higher position, not let her get down so low.
Here's Jean. Now Edwards in the transfer out of Southern Miss, former Golden Eagle. And it's thrown right to Smith. And now Caitlin Smith's got it, pushing it ahead. Trudy Walker, she'll take it to the bucket and score.
What a beautiful play. Nice dish down low and a great effort play by Trudy to bounce it off the glass and in.
These two teams in the previous meeting, it was a Panthers win, 85-76. That was back on the 28th of January. The force it inside, an easy bucket for Alexis Jean, who's on the board.
Yeah, good move right there down low. Good post up. You can see why she's a big-time player, sophomore, for Coach Rufo.
Smith will carry it up. Titans down two early going. Want to get Victoria Morales going here. Walker will drive the baseline, and she's going to be packed out of bounds.
Wow, big block there, Jonica. Garvin down low, obviously going to Mississippi State, but I do like what Taylor Smith did for the Titans. She kind of set a screen to kind of open up for Trudy, but Garvin said, nope, not gonna happen.
Smith on, and now Caitlin will be denied any three-point opportunity. Taylor Smith trying to arc that baby in, could not. On the run is Jean. Edwards will cross things over. The pass was cut off. Spins underneath the basket. Crazy shot. And Walker's got the rebound for Eastern Florida. Still down 4-2. Slow start, really, offensively for both teams.
Yeah, Trudy's averaged 22 rebounds in the past two games. She's off to a great start, number 24.
Alexis Sparkman in the game, defending Morales. Now Smith will launch the long three. It's contested.
Yeah.
And it's an air ball.
It looked like Jonica Garvin just got a little piece of that.
Ball movement. And then the long three rattles out. As Jean slow starting right now. Caitlin Smith on the run. And timeout called by Eastern Florida.
Stoppage of play. Good timeout right there. But again, right now, just kind of the storyline so far is that Palm Beach State has got some good shots. They're not falling in, but the Titans are turning the ball over. They need to settle down, get some good looks like to Trudy Walker down low, get some high percentage of shots, Jeff.
I look at the Palm Beach State College Panthers, and they remind me of the Titans last year who won the championship in this conference for the second year in a row. Very sophomore-dominated team. And they're hanging in there right now, Trudy.
That's just a beautiful pass for Caitlin Smith to see that Trudy got behind the defensive coverage. And just a great, talented play by Trudy to finish it off. And that they need to do more of that. Trudy is so special down low. And Taylor Smith, being a sophomore out of Sebastian, Florida, she's got to create some space down low to Trudy to really get her off on the offensive side of the ball.
Talk about Nene Johnson, Paola Vasquez, Crystal Townsend, Emma Grimes, all those talented players that started a year ago. along with Trudy. And Trudy, the sole leader of this team, keeping the ship together.
Caitlin right here, this is an opportunity for her to key up the offense right here. But she's got to take care of the basketball, create some looks for other players.
Smith then unable to do that as Jean got in the way. Thinking about the pull-up is Sequoia Edwards. Along the baseline, this is Sparkman. And now the long three off the mark, and again, slow start offensively. Field goal percentage dropping drastically for both sides.
Got to take it the basket. There it is.
Trudy Walker has all four of the Titans' points here, and she'll shoot another. So going for the lead here from the foul line.
She gets an end one right there. Beautiful play, as we talked about earlier. As you can see, number 23, Cache Johnson, comes in for the first time for the Panthers. Is that work that down low? It seems like it's effective. So far, so good. Keep working it.
Walker, 63% free throw shooter, and gets the shooter's roll there. And Titans have the lead. Dora Odia, or Odia, tomato, tomato. It's been a conversation we've had all season.
Good looking player, Lagos, Nigeria, Odia. And right now it's a Trudy Walker show with 5 points. It's always good working with you, Jeff.
Likewise. And that one swishes through, making it rain, Sequoia Edwards.
Yep, and that's the player that keys up things for Palm Beach State.
7-5, Odia denied, Walker as well. Tell you what, Patricia Albert in there, 6-3, causing a disturbance. Drive, and the shot does not go. Walker battles for the board.
Look at Trudy Walker, I love it. Aggressive rebound too. This is where they need to set it up though. Let Trudy get down low. Because worst case, if you don't get the high percentage shot, you get a chance for Trudy to pick up another board.
For that Morales, Odia, shot clock down to 7. Thinking about the shots, long range on the way, clanks off. But a big rebound there for Victoria Morales.
There we go, Vic. You got to reset it right here.
Puts it on the floor. Take it to the hoop and denied by number 15 again. 1.1 blocks per game, Patricia Albert. You see why.
Yeah, Patricia Albert, really long player. Ooh. And bam, they make him pay.
Sparkman out of West Palm Beach, Lake Worth. 12 points on 4 three-pointers against Eastern Florida in that first meeting. She's got her first.
And Jeff, you can see the difference right now too, how many substitutions Palm Beach State has orchestrated to only one for the Titans.
Yeah, certainly the deeper side. Palm Beach on a 15-game win streak. Heck, they've only lost twice all season to Daytona State and Central Florida, College of Central Florida.
Yeah, pretty impressive run. You know, 15 straight, and obviously Palm Beach State captured the Southern Conference title with an 85-54 road win against Florida Southwestern State College. Good luck at Trudy Walker.
And clanks the first.
But you know, Trudy wants the basketball. She wants to finish. The last time she was on Inside Titan Sports, she wanted that rebounding record. And Jeff, you'd be so proud of her effort. She wants the basketball. Tonight she's bringing it. Feed Trudy Walker. If that's one woman show, so be it. Feed Trudy Walker.
This is them both that time. Talking about sophomores last night as Edwards loses grip for a second. As Kareem Bruton went off for 26 points, 28 points, something like 36 rather.
Yeah.
On senior night.
So happy for Coach Jeremy Shulman. Fifth straight title. Yeah. What a good dude. Great coach.
Shot clock to 7. Crossing over. Good looking player there and stepping out of bounds. Yes.
Good defense for the Titans right there to kind of force her to the baseline. She ran out of real estate, goes out of bounds. Turnover for the Panthers.
Trudy, a much-deserved break. Taylor Smith, the other sophomore out of Sebastian, Florida. Transfer from Kennesaw State, just like Alexis Jean. So her former teammate going up against her tonight.
Some great schools you talk about there, Jeff.
And Smith didn't get the touch, so it will be Titan ball.
Good denial down low by Jonica Garvin for Palm Beach State, but I do like the way they're trying to feed Taylor Smith.
Long inbound. Odia on the floor and ripped away by Patricia Albert.
Good no call, could have been a travel.
Leaving it to Edwards and then Cache Johnson out of Chicago gets the bucket.
Good bucket. Give it to Taylor. Finish, Taylor.
She'll go to the line. Titans down 7. Smith, a 57% free throw shooter. We'll have a couple of free throws here. And, boy, you keep you've already alluded to it. The Panthers just running numbers right now.
Yeah, they rotate fresh legs, and that really can catch up with you right now. And a good shot right there. Good rotation for Taylor Smith to get her first point of the ball game. Starting tonight is one of the sophomores, one of the two. You always want to see a player that's put some time into a program to finish strong.
Yeah, all-out effort, Taylor Smith, all season. Second one on the way. It's some both.
So there's a player right there, Jeff, you want to look for. Shakoya Edwards. This young lady, if you can get a key on her defensively for the Titans, you got a good chance to kind of upset the Panthers.
Sophomore out of Boynton Beach. Work it around when you have ball down low. 3 seconds.
Yeah, 3 second violation. Good defense right there. Good recognition by the official to see that she's kind of hanging out in that paint. You got to call it to set the tone the rest of the game.
Tough to miss Sparkman or Albert, 6-0 and 6-3.
Yeah, they create some space, don't they?
Cruz going up against Edwards. Odia. And knocked out of bounds. Good effort there from Palm Beach State and Cache Johnson.
Got to be more efficient with the passing game right now. I like the way they're being aggressive for the Titans down low, but you're just being a little reckless with those passes. Take that extra look, extra time, let the player get set in the corner, then make that move.
Inbound to Morales. Back on the ball, Caitlin Smith. Shot clock at 6. Not much room to work. Smith will get the shot up with 2 on the clock and drain it.
Sophomore magic, Jeff Radcliffe, Taylor Smith for 2.
Cuts the lead to 2. That's what you want from your sophomore. Putting it on the ground, Edwards. And that one off the mark. Big rebound, Odia. Caitlin Smith.
Just take care of the basketball.
Kicking it out, Odia for 3. And off the mark, and easy rebound as Albert corrals it. And then bothered by Cruz and nearly gave it up.
Well, obviously I'd love to see the 3-point basket go down for Odia, but you gotta make that extra pass, because in transition, you make the extra pass, you get a higher percentage shot.
Edwards setting up shot. 40 seconds to go in this opening quarter. It's been a good one. 3-point advantage for the visitors. Edwards will pop from 3. That time off the front iron, the back, the cleanup on aisle 15 for Patricia Albert.
Yeah, Taylor's got a little bit better to blocking out, not allowing Albert to get in there and get that cleanup bucket.
Remember Trudy Walker on the bench getting a rest. Odia takes it to the basket for 2.
Good slash move for Odia right there.
10 seconds left in the quarter. Edwards trying to recognize. Will make her move, 5 seconds, now 4. Working it down low, Garvin, shot off the mark. And Eastern Florida has the rebound as time expires. They trail by 3 at the end of 1.
Well, I tell you what, good first quarter by Eastern Florida. Palm Beach State obviously has missed a high percentage of their shots, but the biggest thing is I think the defensive effort for the Titans really has forced them into pushing their shots up a little bit. So kudos to the Titans. Now the Titans, though, offensively, Jeff, they gotta take care of the basketball. Too many ill-advised passes down low, and Trudy's playing a good game. So hey, right now, so far, so good for the Titans.
And hanging right in there, down 3 with the best player getting a breather right now. And that's what you need. She's the great equalizer down low.
Well, I think it's just a great opportunity. Again, Palm Beach State is playing with house money. They've already wrapped up the title, already wrapped up conference. They're already getting ready for the next level of the playoffs. Eastern Florida, emotional game. Jim Grimes passing, couple sophomores. So, hey, you got an opportunity. But just Coach Steph has always said, hey, we need a 40-minute game. We saw that against Indian River. Tonight is the same opportunity. Trudy looks like she wants to play. Take care of the basketball. Give yourself that extra pass, and you got better percentage.
Panthers undefeated in Southern Conference play. Here's why. They can score at will at times. As Edwards, effortless there from the outside.
She's got a good look, Shakoya Edwards. And right here, you can see on the outside, they make that pass, bam. Alexis Sparkman But right there, Albert takes the ball away, gives it to Sequoia, and you just can't turn the ball over because Palm Beach State makes you pay.
Eastern Florida yet to connect on a three-pointer. Haven't seen Mariah Bates do much yet with Cruz on the floor. Odia building the confidence, the freshman kicking it out.
There we go.
Smith for three.
Beautiful.
Money.
Right there, just like we talked about the break right there. Get him down low, high, low. You kick it on the outside, you get a better look. She drains it.
And I had just said, no Titans three. And Smith took care of that.
Could you tell me that I've never won the lottery? That might work out for me. I could flip
You've
that
You've never
around.
Won the lottery.
Yeah, so that way now I'll win the lottery with what you just did with that three-point basket.
I expect to pay off here next week then.
It's good to see Michael Jordan is in the house today. All the celebrities have come out to Titan Fieldhouse.
Caitlin Smith is the ball quickly to the floor.
Got to take care of the basketball.
There from Edwards.
They go to possession.
Edwards low to the floor. Doesn't take her long to get down.
You're right on that. Possession favors Palm Beach State. But I love that extra kick. I can't wait for our truck to come back when we get a little time to look at that extra. Odia goes down, kicks it out to Bates, and it was just a beautiful play there. Obviously, Caitlin Smith, I should say. Just a great offensive play. That's what the Titans need.
Edwards. Boynton Beach. Now it's Cache Johnson. Taking their time, moving the ball around the perimeter. Now we'll dribble drive. A little floater does not fall for Johnson.
Another
Smith
board.
On the move, looking for the lead here. We'll put up the layup. No, Walker the rebound and can't get the shot to fall, but she'll shoot for the lead from the foul line.
Look at that, Jeff. Trudy goes down, gets a defensive board, comes down, gets the offensive board. Just great hustle play for number 24. And Crystal Williams picks up her second personal foul. So the Trudy Walker show so far so good for the Titans.
Walker, one of three now, 2 of 4 from the line.
She gets her 6 point, Palm Beach State substitution. Alexis Sparkman comes in, hit that earlier three in our replay.
That one off the mark. So 1 point lead for the Titans here in the second quarter. Edwards and company refusing to back down though. Calm and confident, as you expect the conference champs to be.
It's a good spot here, Jeff. I like to force Palm Beach State to slow them down, make them work for that offensive set.
Boy, backing in, left-handed shot.
Wow, beautiful.
It swishes for Jonica Garvin.
That was just a beautiful shot right there. She gets on the board.
Top of the key, Odia feigns the three, drives to the foul line then. The left-handed shot is a good one. She worked in on Sparkman and scored it.
What great athletic ability to contort your body like that to make that move off the glass and in. Nice shot, Odia.
Back and forth we go, Titans in front one. Johnson. Haven't seen Gene open things up yet. And Edwards, one and done.
Good clear out for Morales to get the rebound.
Cruz to Odia, kicking it out. Three on the way. It's off the mark. Big rebound, Walker.
Trudy.
The putback is good.
Wow, Trudy's come to play. 8 point of the night, Jeff. I love her energy down low, getting those boards.
3 point advantage for the home team. Quick turnaround shot off the mark. Still cold from the field is Alexis Jean. And Odia missed opportunity as it goes off her hands. We'll bring it back to the Panthers.
Well, a little anxious moment right there. You know, you saw you had a fast break moment, but you got to take care of the basketball. Got away from her, but it's going to happen. I like the way they're pushing the envelope right here. Taylor Smith tries to check in. It's too late getting to the table right there. So she'll be coming in with Taylor Smith.
Substitution pattern going to be so key for
You're
the
right.
Titans coaching staff here tonight.
Other thing is, too, is Palm Beach State has 17 fouls right now. I'd keep working them. Get them a little foul trouble here, Jeff.
I like it. Turn around, Gene, and a very Trudy Walker-like putback for Jonica Garvin.
That's a beautiful play for Jonica Garvin. You can see why she's going to Mississippi State. Good position down low.
future Bulldog. Former Auburn Tiger. Contested shot for Odia. Coming out of there is Khadijah Huggins. And now running the court, Alexis Jean gets on the board.
You know, good basketball, Alexis Jean right there, number 25 for Palm Beach State. She deflects the shot on the offensive side, right? Takes it down and finishes it off. Plays both sides of the court. That's a basketball player for you.
Panthers back in front. That was her fourth point for Jean. Odia. A little baseline J for Victoria Morales. Yeah. It's her first bucket of the night.
I like the way she squared up her shoulders there. Good shot, good pass, good recognition. She drains it.
Titans in front by one. How about Cruz out jumping everybody? Cruising down the field. Former player of the year in her conference in Las Vegas. And now going to the line will be Eastern Florida one more time.
That's a big foul right there. Alexis Jean picks up her second personal. And that's the eighth team foul. Good move by Morales, but I really like the way you said Brooklyn Cruz, number 22 for your Titans. She takes it down in the middle of the court and kicks it out, draws the defenders to her, and Morales saw it, takes it to the court. Now she gets two shots.
Cruz, a two-time All-Suncoast Region at Palo Verde High School in Las Vegas, as Morales hits the first free throw.
Taylor Smith and Mariah Bates will check back in for your Titans. And Patricia Albert, 6'3" sophomore in Chicago, checks in for the Panthers.
Makes them both 23-20 for the home side.
Great teams. Offensive set there, Jeff. Now they got to get back. This is how they kept themselves in the game to get the lead. Play defense.
Long ball, short.
Bad shot.
Cruz running things. Working it in on Edwards, who is feisty and quick, going for the steal. She's got it and takes it out of bounds. She's pushed.
Wow, kind of an odd call. They're both going for the basketball. I thought that would just be an out-of-bounds situation. But they're gonna whistle on Brooklyn Cruz. Interesting.
Okay.
Crowd doesn't like it, and I agree with them. I mean, it was a great effort play by Shakoya Edwards, don't get me wrong, but the fact is Brooklyn Cruz didn't push her for the foul. It's a play on.
Edwards take it to the hole and score two more.
Yep.
Edwards has five.
Yep. She makes you pay. She's a player. She makes a move on defense, makes a finish on offense.
Makes a quick take, doesn't she?
Right.
Long three on the way. It's going to be an air ball. Didn't quite come off the hands that Victoria thought that it was going to be.
Those are empty possessions right there. I mean, it's great if it goes. It's one of those like no, 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 yes. But the fact is, you go down, the offense is not even set for the second chance rebound. It's you can't do that against Palm Beach State team.
Conference champs now, Crystal Williams, 3.6 assists per game, running the show. Huggins, Williams, quick ball movement here from the Panthers. Off balance, shot doesn't fall. Morales the rebound.
Good defense, that's not the question. Get those extra sets.
Smith 10 on 10. And was this tipped? It was tipped. So it'll be recovered by Victoria Morales. Shot clock though down to 14, now 13. Cruz will have to put things in operation quickly.
Good ball game, Jeff, to this point.
Cruz, right down Broadway, and one.
Wow, I like that and one. That is outstanding.
And the foul on Garvin.
Wow. That's another big foul against the big three. The big three is Shakoya Edwards, Alexis Jean, and Jonica Garvin. Let's see if Cruz can knock this thing down.
Minimal attempts. 25% free throw shooter coming in.
Here comes
and completes the three-point play. Go ahead.
Here's the two players that are coming in now for the Titans now. Trudy Walker comes in, and obviously Dora Odia has had a good game to this point. So, hey. They get a little bit of rest. They come in. They're nursing a four-point lead. Pretty good for the Titans.
Titans by four here against the team that's undefeated in conference play at 10-0. Trying to go 12-0 on the season with a win in their final two contests. Got to get by the Titans first. Little kick out. Three on the way from Garvin. And nothing doing. Odia the rebound out in front of Albert.
Good defense to force him into quick shot.
Bates high, arcing three, swishes through.
Wow, Bates gets on the board with a big 3-7-point lead for the Titans.
29-22, and Bates comes up with a loose ball. Boy, Titans feeling it right now. Odia inside, Walker, and one. Yeah.
Oh,
it's offensive foul. Ouch.
Basket is good. Basket's good.
So basket does not count.
It's disallowed right there, but I tell you what, I was looking at both officials. One looks like he was counting the two and the and one, but then the near side ref called him off and said it was a charge. Wow, that'd have been big right there.
Hurts. Walker picks up the personal.
I like the aggressive play though, Jeff.
Putting on the floor down low. Shaboy Edwards will come out with it. Boy, all sorts of speed as she crosses over. Her go-to spin move draws the foul.
Yeah, it's kind of a blender move. Dominic Wilkins called that his blender.
A little spin cycle.
Taylor gets her second personal down low.
Edwards to the line, a 63% free throw shooter.
She's got 5 points so far. Again, she is the key of success on the court for Palm Beach State.
Makes the first, cuts the lead to six.
She's a bit of a slasher too, though.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, she just goes underneath everybody.
Yeah, well, she's got that speed and the athletic ability to make that move.
And makes both free throws. 29-24, Titans now facing a little half press. Quickly backed out. Tell you what though, Huggins and Edwards won women presses. They've created some turnovers and some havoc. Walker. No way, offensive foul.
Wow.
Second personal.
We'll have to check
that. I don't know about that, but
yeah.
Okay. We're home announcers, we can say that.
No, I mean, I call it objectively. I just think that was an interesting call to even have that as a foul. Morales checks back in for Titans, number 21. But right now, just keep playing the defense. So I tell you what, keep playing defensive set right here. Let's see, look down low here. She was moving.
Wow. I don't know. I don't think the defender was set.
Good job by the truck there.
Again, referees don't have the benefit of replay.
Yeah, but I mean, Albert wasn't even set at all. She was moving. Water under the bridge now, though, Jeff.
Yep. Got to play defense. Edwards pulls up at the foul line, clanks off the iron. Bates looking for the loose ball, gets it away, and she's fouled.
Yeah, that's a little makeup call right there, loose ball foul.
I think you said it right there.
She picks up her first personal. Titans need to set some things up right here. Start working that clock. I'm not saying preserve your lead here, but just they're playing great on the half court set defensively. They need to get that extra look, reverse the basketball on the offense.
Bates, now Dia, not gonna let her shoot, was Albert. Winding down towards that 2 minute mark of this first half. Odia, and the shot was altered. Picked back up by Palm Beach, Crystal Williams.
Let's get back set. There you go, force Palm Beach State. Force the situation to get uncomfortable here.
Down low, off the glass, and good. Patricia Albert, her fourth point, and it's gonna be a timeout for the Titans here. Their lead has shrunk to three.
Well, I mean, the biggest thing is you just got to take care of the basketball. You're going to have ebbs and flows, and when you're playing a team like Palm Beach State, that's obviously 21-2 on the year, 10-0 in conference, they're going to have some runs at you. But you got to take care of the basketball. I am so impressed, though, to this point, Jeff, about the way the Titans are really forcing Palm Beach State to kind of not get those clean looks. They have missed some of those baskets, but it's been attributed to the defensive effort. But offensively, they've got to take care of the basketball for the Titans because Palm Beach State can score at will. So take care of the basketball. You don't need empty sets.
Eastern Florida State College in the last 11 days, a double overtime win against Miami-Dade, then yeah. The win here Saturday against Indian River, 91-52, running on all cylinders.
Yep.
And right now hanging right in there with the top team in the conference, Palm Beach State.
Well, tonight's all about that JG sticker on the Titans jersey for Coach Jim Grimes. This would be a great win watching over us.
Smith.
Ooh, good luck.
Get it to fall. Coming away is Crystal Williams.
Now, see, that was a good look.
Boy, quick ball movement down low. Corinthia Lindsay is on the board.
Yep, that was a good look down low for Palm Beach State, but I like the look and the shot for the Titans on the other side of the basketball.
That got the bench of Palm Beach State up after that score. Morales puts it on the floor, pulls up, shot was altered, and she'll continue to battle for the loose ball. Taylor Smith checking her eye right now.
Trisha Albert's shaking up on the play for Palm Beach State.
She's getting back into it now.
Under a minute to play.
Three for Edwards off the mark. Again, gets her own rebound. Wasn't boxed out, scores. Palm Beach State back in front, 30-29. Timeout, Titans.
Yeah, I tell you what, 8-0 run by Palm Beach State. And again, they can score at will, but you cannot give them garbage baskets like that just happened on that set right there. But a good heads up play by Shakoy Edwards to pick it up and put it away.
So missed the shot, but that not going to be happy is going to be one Stephanie Schaefer and Gabriel Duran with that one.
Well, and Taylor Smith right there had an opportunity to kind of block out. She was kind of in the paint, no man's land. That's a situation. You got that big body. Come out in space. Don't let anybody get that backdoor basket.
So Coach Gary there as well. 46.3. Titans trying to pull off the upset of upsets. Again, how they play is what Stephanie Schaefer has been telling us the last couple of weeks. You want to play the Jim Grimes way. They do that.
That's right.
Wins can happen. Obviously, you'd want that to happen. But if you play the way that the coach wanted you, that she's going to be happy with that.
That's big. You got to play 40 minutes. You run into a buzzsaw right here. Great opportunity. If you said you're down one against this team right now, you'd be in a good situation. They're right there. Just got to finish the game here.
Backing it out. Cruz will put it on the floor and pull it up for two more.
Boy, I tell you what, I like her shot, like her energy. You can see why she had a career high 16 points against Indian River. She logs in her fifth point. Big bucket.
Titans back in front. And the shot clock is off. Playing for the last shot of this half. Perhaps a lead for Palm Beach State College. Clock down to six. Edwards makes her move, a little kick out to Huggins. Shot clock, the clock down to one, and it's banked in. Khadijah Huggins able to lock that one down. The sophomore out of Tarpon Springs at the buzzer gives her side the 1-point lead, 32-31. So Huggins' first bucket comes at a good time right at the end of the half. But the Titans hanging in. Down by one against the top team in the Southern Conference. And our Eric Kohler is with one of the interim head coaches of Eastern Florida, Stephanie Schaefer.
Hey guys, Coach Schaefer here. Coach, back and forth game.
Yeah.
But good energy so far. What do you think about your Titans?
Yeah, I'm pleased that we're in this. You know, offensively, we really struggled executing in the first quarter, so I was pleased with some better execution in the second quarter offensively. But yeah, we've let a few loose balls go their way, and I'd like to see us, you know, get the defensive stop and the rebound.
Well, I tell you what, defensively, you really forced Palm Beach State in some bad spots.
Yeah.
But you just got to convert that on the offensive side of the ball. What's your message at halftime going to be to address that?
We need 20 more minutes, and we got to play together. We got to want it more than they do.
Well, you go get it, Coach. Good luck.
Thanks, Eric. Appreciate it.
Tell you what, this is a good half. 32-31, your Titans are holding in against Palm Beach State. Stick around. It's going to be a great second half. You're watching Continue Action on WEFS.
Join local sportscaster Eric Kohler as he hosts Eastern Florida State College coaches and student athletes for a closer look inside Titan sports. Produced in partnership with Florida Today, the weekly in-depth program covers the 11 Titans men's and women's sports teams through game footage and coaches' analysis. Get closer to the action Thursday night at 8 here on WEFS. As the Eastern Florida softball team prepares for the spring season on a new field at the Melbourne campus, head coach Ed Yanis talked to the media about the challenges of having only two returning players.
This has been a different year. We've had a large freshman class, as you mentioned, so it's different, but it's fun. At the same time, it's a lot of learning, a lot more teaching maybe goes on, because we have our two young ladies that are coming up next, our sophomores, that'll give a chance to take the teaching for them when I'm not around to give them maybe a different insight of what it takes to be a freshman here, because they learned it. Some maybe learned a little bit harder than others, but they're still back, and it's good. I'm not afraid of it, and I don't think they are either. I think they're ready to lead. So for them to take the reins and show these freshmen how it works, it's going to be a fast, exciting season.
I think that we have strong players in every position that we need, and we're gelling better. I think we're getting to know each other better, and I think the outcome, because of the gelling and the working better and being strong on the field and off the field, definitely is going to help us. But
it's definitely going to be a different process trying to come together, as there are so many freshmen and it's only me and Carly leading them. We're going to have to focus more on trying to be leaders and actually taking them and having them like follow in our direction. Going to the new field, we have a locker room. We can actually keep our stuff in. We don't have to take it home every day. The field, the dirt is so much faster than the other field. And being from Las Vegas, I'm kind of used to that, so I like that aspect better.
So check the website for game dates and time, and come out and support your Titans. Admission is free.
You know, we have a lot of energetic girls. We're going to put on a show this season. I think we're going to do great.
Fast-paced, exciting game in a phenomenal facility.
My wife is currently in the Air Force, so I decided to be a stay-at-home father.
I'm a retiree and a full-time student.
I did online classes because I was traveling and it was easy to take the classes with me.
I am graduating today with my bachelor's in business administration.
If it wasn't for the online classes, I would not be standing here today.
There shouldn't be any procrastination. Just get out there and go do it.
This is where we're building the future. This is where we meet the challenge, where leaders emerge and careers take flight. This is where you discover new opportunities. Choose to stand where excellence lives, where Titans rise. Eastern Florida State College.
Join local sportscaster Eric Kohler as he hosts Eastern Florida State College coaches and student athletes for a closer look inside Titan sports. Produced in partnership with Florida Today, the weekly in-depth program covers the 11 Titans men's and women's sports teams through game footage and coaches' analysis. Get closer to the action Thursday night at 8 here on WEFS.
Halftime at the Titan Field House as Eastern Florida State College, a one-point deficit here at halftime, 32-31. Jeff Radcliffe, Eric Kohler. You know, being a normally a soccer announcer, right, there's a saying called getting stuck in.
That's right.
It means get in defensively, really make it tough. And I thought it's exactly what the Titans are doing here against the team that's going to win the conference this year.
Well, I mean, the biggest thing is, Jeff, right now, that, you know, obviously the Titans come in kind of depleted on the bench. Palm Beach State comes in very hot, haven't lost since the first week of December. But the fact of the matter is I really like the defensive effort right now. I talked to Coach Schaefer. I like the way they're forcing Palm Beach State and some sets down low. But they got to convert those to get points on the offensive side of the ball. That's going to be the biggest adjustment. If they do that, I really think the Titans have a good chance to sneak out here with a big win.
As we look at some of the highlights from that first half, I would like just to point out 9 different players have scored for the Panthers. Eastern Florida only has 9 available to play, so that just gives you an idea how deep this team is. But look at Eastern Florida really battling with Trudy Walker. She's got 8.
I just love the energy of Trudy Walker, just down low, just fighting for those rebounds. And right here, Morales, good step right there on the baseline, drains the 3. Now check out this for Brooklyn Cruz. So glad to have her back. Nice slash move, takes a shot to the face and finishes. And check this out, another player, as you said, only 9 players available. Nice pass, shoulders set. Look at this, drains it. Bates, with the 3. And then here we go, down low. Look at this, Odia, good recognition. Walker's coming down, good hustle play. And the finish, Trudy Walker. She wants to finish in style, sophomore sensation.
Had a couple of offensive fouls. It might be questionable, but what does she do to react to that? Because you know now they know she wants to go to the hoop.
Right.
How does she need to? Does she need to take a little edge off, or does she continue to play the way she's supposed to play?
Just continue to play. I mean, right now she's breaking it down the offensive side of the ball, defensive side of the ball. I'm so proud of her effort right now. But right now they gotta cash in on defensive effort to get some scores because Palm Beach State can score, and they got defensively keep that intensity up. But I'm gonna tell you what, Stephanie Schaefer, Gabby Duran, they got a chance to pull off the upset here in Titan Fieldhouse.
Sequoia Edwards with 9 points to lead all scorers, averaging 11.9. She's been very impressive, number one. Very, very quick on the first step and also can shoot the rock.
Well, and again, they have the big 3. I call them the triplets, but the fact of the matter is, you know, so far, the Titans have forced them to some shots they're not comfortable with. They're not getting set. They're not getting the clear air that they want. So, you know, obviously you can have explosive players. They're highly talented. Coach told us that before the game, but the fact of the matter is, just keep playing ball, Titans. This is a good game. I'm glad everybody's tuning in.
Both teams back on the floor to get ready for their third quarter warm-ups. We'll take a quick timeout when we come back. It is second half action between the Titans of Eastern Florida, the Panthers of Palm Beach. It is sophomore night for the 2 sophomores from the Titans. It's been a good start. They trail by 1.
Join local sportscaster Eric Kohler as he hosts Eastern Florida State College coaches and student athletes for a closer look inside Titan sports. Produced in partnership with Florida Today, the weekly in-depth program covers the 11 Titans men's and women's sports teams through game footage and coaches' analysis. Get closer to the action Thursday night at 8 here on WEFS. In his 15th season as head coach of the Eastern Florida men's golf team, Jamie Howell and his golfers recently spoke to the media about the fall season and upcoming spring campaign.
It was a good fall to get the feet wet. You know, I got to see a lot of golf. I got to see an awful lot of what they look like in competition. It gives me information as we go into the spring.
I think in the fall, we slowly found our feet and got used to competitive golf for the new team. And now I feel like we got to believe we can win. Because we've got the game, and we showed signs in the fall that we can win. Like we got close a few times.
Yeah, for me personally, of course I'd like to win an event. I got pretty close to the last event of last semester. So for me to break through that door would be great. More importantly, the team. We came second twice last semester, which was okay, but a team like Eastern Florida with the history that we do, we need to be winning events. And all the guys in the roster know that.
Well, first of all, it started a little rough. I just trying to get used to the environment, but after I got that first tournament on my belt, I became more confident and score starting to get lower and playing much better. Well, I mean, of course we want to get that first win on our belt, but overall, we just got to keep our composure. We can't look much further than the first event that we have coming up.
Our expectation for this spring really is just to go out there and show what we can do. Last year's spring, we did pretty well, and this year's spring, we have the same motivations and dedications going into it.
So check the website for game dates and time, and come out and support your Titans. Admission is free.
We just got to keep working hard, and we will break through the door and get that win.
My wife is currently in the Air Force, so I decided to be a stay-at-home father.
I'm a retiree and a full-time student.
I did online classes because I was traveling and it was easy to take the classes with me.
I am graduating today with my bachelor's in business administration.
If it wasn't for the online classes, I would not be standing here today.
There shouldn't be any procrastination. Just get out there and go do it.
This is where we're building the future. This is where we meet the challenge, where leaders emerge and careers take flight. This is where you discover new opportunities. Choose to stand where excellence lives, where Titans rise. Eastern Florida State College.
Join local sportscaster Eric Kohler as he hosts Eastern Florida State College coaches and student athletes for a closer look inside Titan sports. Produced in partnership with Florida Today, the weekly in-depth program covers the 11 Titans men's and women's sports teams through game footage and coaches' analysis. Get closer to the action Thursday night at 8 here on WEFS.
Back at the Titan Fieldhouse on the campus of Eastern Florida State College, getting set for third quarter action between Eastern Florida and Palm Beach State College. Jeff Radcliffe alongside Eric Kohler. And Eric, what adjustments, if any, if you're Palm Beach State, because you're in a battle here against a team on paper anyway that you should have the better of?
Well, with Palm Beach State right now, but basically you just have to get them to be like, get them energized again. Right now, again, they're playing with house money. They've already done that conference title. It was kind of a challenge to get here tonight with the weather in the area. So right now, maybe they were just kind of late arriving mentally. For the Titans, biggest thing is keep that defensive effort, but start cashing in on the offensive side of the ball. We got ourselves a good one.
Eastern Florida now going right to left as you see it here on WEFS. So glad to have you along. Forcing it into Smith, and a nice steal there from Alexis Sparkmina out of West Palm Beach. So playing their hometown school.
Good denial down low. Now this is defensively, they've done a pretty good job. The Titans, that is. Got to continue that energy.
Got to get it out of the hands of Shakora Edwards. Long ball off the mark, tracking down the rebound. Caitlin Smith for Eastern Florida. They're down one here at the start of the third.
Hey, right now for the Titans, this is your championship right here in one game. Everything encompasses right here. Each possession matters.
Final game of the home schedule. One more at ASA, but they're thinking this one right now as the sharpshooter Victoria Morales gives them the lead.
Like that shot. Good spot up again, squaring those shoulders. Great shot in the corner. Big three-point basket.
She's got seven. Panthers getting all they can handle right now. Top of the key, they work it low. Smith disrupted things. And Eastern Florida will have it again.
Good denial right there. Taylor Smith, one of the sophomores. Biggest thing about her plans after completing her education, she wants to become an EMT firefighter and pan forward. So good to see that she's having a good same so far on sophomore night.
Amen to that. Bates pulls it down. Smith. Palm Beach defending mightily here. Tell you what, Eastern Florida's had to work for the shot. There's no doubt about that. That one off the mark, the little runner from Morales. Walker gets the rebound, and she walked with the basketball.
Wow, that's an interesting call. She never had possession of the basketball right there, but I don't know. Looks like she kind of got hit across the arm nevertheless.
Well, the assistant, the official that called it was on the back side there.
Yeah, he didn't have the best visual right there. That's a big call. I thought Trudy, that was a good effort play to get it, but nevertheless, Palm Beach State basketball.
Trailing by two. Edwards dribbling furiously. A low bounce pass, turnaround shot on the way is money for Alexis Jean. Jean, who had just 4 points at the half, she averages 19.
Yep, good defense right there. Shows you shutting down their top scorer. Thought she shuffled her feet a little bit. Nevertheless, count the deuce.
Down low, Smith to Walker. Mm. Little high.
Got to stop the basketball.
This is Jean, and just getting in the way and being a pest. And is Caitlin Smith charged for the foul.
It's a good foul right there. You got to stop the basketball. Worst case scenario, force them to make the two with the charity stripe. Substitutions, Odia comes back in. She's actually been kind of a catalyst energizer for the Titans to this point. And Cache Johnson in for Palm Beach State.
Palm Beach will inbound the basketball under their basket.
Oh, wow, that was a great foul. They said it was on the floor, so not even shots.
Take that.
Yeah, great play by Caitlin Smith. You know, it's just been a tribute to the whole coaching staff of the sudden loss of Jim Grimes, of Cabby Duren, Stephanie Schaefer, Matt Provencil, and Gary Woodmansey, just to really pick up the reins after such a sudden and tragic loss of such a wonderful man.
It's certainly a team effort as far as the coaching staff goes to pick up the slack and keep these ladies motivated.
It's something that's touched us all, and it'd be great to finish out the home slate with a big win against Palm Beach State.
A lot of energy there from Jean coming out of the locker room with like gangbusters. Couldn't get the shot to fall, though.
Like the energy, got away with a walk right there. Got to make him pay. Get it down to Trudy.
Instead, three in the corner is good for Mariah Bates. Got a vision of threes right there.
Second trifecta of the night. Good set to find that pass in the corner, and Jim Grimes would be smiling. The biggest thing of Jim Grimes basketball, he wanted a lot of ball movement, that extra pass, and reverse the basketball. And that's what they did right there. Jim Grimes is smiling in heaven right now.
3-point lead for Eastern Florida here. 6:48 just underway in this third quarter, the third half.
All works out the same.
Yeah, sometimes you just get caught saying two things.
Hey, that's one of those things in broadcasting, Jeff. You learn with all the good stuff you do with Orlando City Soccer, you just keep moving on.
Yeah.
Bus keeps on rolling.
Hey, just have fun. None of us are perfect. Oh, getting that low entry pass.
Wow, sure was a good pass.
Over the ground, driving the baseline, turned over.
Great defense to the baseline.
Caitlin Smith, Bates, cross court pass, Zia pulls it down.
There she is.
And Walker can't get the shot. She'll shoot two, though.
See, right there. Again, that extra pass. The extra pass allows the defender is late to break down and collapse in the offensive player. Big play. Good heads-up play.
So she won't shoot. It was on the floor. Inbound Eastern Florida.
But that's a big foul there. Alexis Jean, their go-to, picks up her third personal foul. Fouls are becoming a problem for Palm Beach State and the Panthers.
Bates off the screen. Yeah, make it rain. Mariah Bates, a sweet fantasy baby right there, Mariah.
She gets the third trifecta. 9 points. And what an answer.
Donegan Garvin on the other end.
She's like, don't forget about me. I'm part of the big three. Great answer. Great players make great plays.
Bates. And nearly gave it away. That's on me. It'll stay with Eastern Florida, though.
This game's really going to come down to who wants it more defensively, in my opinion. I really do. You can see right now, both teams are playing good defense. When you create those defensive sets, it gives you better offensive percentages.
Win or lose, keep this in mind. If you're Eastern Florida, remember, a lot of these players, save for Trudy Walker and Taylor Smith, as that one is off the mark from Bates. All of them return. and I'm sure would like to get back to winning a conference title and sending a message, here's what you got next year.
Yep, future's bright. Little quick shot, ill-advised. Again, I like what Bates did on that side. When a shooter's feeling it, you got to put it up. At that time, she was moving. She was never really set. But I like the way she makes it rain. Keep making it rain.
Oh, and thrown right in. A little miscommunication as Johnson gave it right back.
Cache Johnson gave her cash away to the wrong team.
Smith floats it up. Tries to draw a foul. There was nothing, and it will come the other way. And you can hear the crowd not in agreement. Might have been a foul before that one.
Yeah, and that's a big foul.
The incredulous look from the coaching staff.
Yeah, Coach Schaefer and Coach Duran. It's like,
come on, we're up against it. It's a good team already.
Yeah, it's David and Goliath right here. Don't take away Trudy Walker.
Looked like she got hacked, but never know.
It's one of those, you know, I hate to use, it's kind of a ticky-tack foul. The second person that got called for the foul.
Force down low as Morales altered the shot. And just enough and getting the turnover there along the baseline.
Good break there. Looks like Taylor Smith's going to check and replace Trudy Walker. And again, you don't want her to sit down with three fouls because she's feeling it. But Taylor Smith, this is an opportunity. The other sophomore to come in, make your roll, create some presence down low.
Good point. Odia, three-point lead. Eastern Florida here, third quarter, 5 minutes to play. Another ball forced in. The hand speed of Palm Beach is excellent. And that time, that is a foul as Caitlin Smith is feeling the effects.
You know, great recognition for Taylor Smith to see that she was in a bit of a pickle and to see that Caitlin Smith got behind the defensive unit and made him pay.
Certainly worried here for Caitlin right now.
Well, especially when you get like in the eye area. And she does look like she took a shot right there in that right eye. Obviously left eye from your viewer standpoint.
She'll be walked to the bench, so Smith will not be able to shoot the free throws, but we're more worried about health immediately here.
Yeah, she's clearly shaken up there with a shot from our wonderful camera crew. And anytime you take a shot to the head area, obviously with all types of sports these days, you know, with soccer and football and basketball, there's a concussion protocol that's in place. So
let's take a look what happened to Caitlin here.
But good play by Taylor Smith. See that? She saw the collapse of the defense. Heads up play. Just takes it right in the face.
Koa Edwards comes down hard.
Yeah.
And this will be a blow if she can't return.
And she's really been pushing the envelope in terms of on the offensive side of the ball. Really kind of the point guard that's really making things happen. And a good hand by the hometown crew. And again, as you said earlier, some of the stars that are coming back for the future's bright for women's basketball for the Titans. That's one of them right there, number 10, Caitlin Smith.
Had a fabulous freshman year, averaging double figures in scoring. And she will be checked out at the end of the bench for the time being.
And it looks like Brooklyn Cruz, since it's a two-shot situation, Cruz will come in the place of Smith, shooting two shots for your Titans.
First free throw is swished through.
And foul was picked up by Shakoya Edwards. That was her first personal for the Panthers.
Cruz, lane violation, they wave it off.
Oh.
Ouch.
Unforced errors right there.
41-37. Not the first time we've seen that either.
Now you hate to see something that's a complete drain and count it and take it off the board.
Well, you appreciate the effort going after that rebound, no doubt. A little too early. Oh, pass inside, trying to get the turnaround shot, does not fall. Cruz and Smith were battling for it, and apparently it was off of Albert.
Titans a little fortunate there. Looked like it went over two defenders for the Titans. But hey, good defense. You see how they collapse down low and force them into a bad shot. But then there are the turnovers that are keeping Palm Beach State around.
Crystal Williams, an athletic move, coming back for it. The sophomore out of Riverdale, Georgia. Now Edwards on the move. And now she'll be fouled and go to the line and shoot two.
Well, I'll tell you, that's a good foul down low. Taylor Smith, she's got some size and basically sending a message to Palm Beach State. Hey, if you're going to come down low, you're going to pay the price.
Especially after you dished one out at the other end and knocked
take
out
our gal.
10.
We'll take out your gal.
And missing the free throw. is Sequoia Edwards, a 63% shooter from the line.
But that's a big foul for the Titans. That's Taylor Smith's third personal now.
Makes one of two. 41-38. Florida looking to take care of the basketball again. Edwards, all sorts of energy.
Seems like the recurring theme right now. Just the basics of just getting the ball in. Take care, get back to the basics, take care of the basketball. This is gonna come down to a half court set. Who wants it more on the defensive side of the ball?
Chris Rufo knows the Titans down to eight available players right now, and they're gonna put the pressure on.
Stoppage of play has looked like there's a little questionable what the shot clock should be at. And they'll change it to 29. It'll still say inbounds for the Titans.
Odia. Cruz coming back to the ball. Odia has it. Steps on the line. Turnover.
Yeah, just the basics. Getting the ball inbounds right now has become a difficult task. Can't do that against Palm Beach State. This team makes you pay.
Long inbound. They work it down low. Put it on the ground. Garvin, turnaround shot. No. Trying to get out in front, Odia, and again committing a foul was Edwards.
No, there's no foul. Believe it or not, there's no foul. Big contact.
What?
I thought they were going to call a Sequoia for a second personal, and then you're just going to say the ball went out of bounds, but it'll be inbounds play from the sideline for the Titans. I'm curious about that as well.
Well, the camera crew will
look good board by Morales. Oh, that's clearly a foul. Loose ball foul. She drills her on the shoulder.
Cruz into the threes. And Palm Beach large and in charge right now. Now they turn it over.
This game's got ugly.
Down low to Cruz. Kicking it back out. Morales baseline J. It's a tough shot. But Walker back in. She's fouled.
Good play by Trudy Walker
and
to get it back in.
Patricia Albert is complaining.
Well, you're right there, you could see just the whole play, that whole set right there was discombobulated. And the fact of the matter is Trudy had that heads up play to get it down, put it up. But right there, that was a time just to slow it down.
Walker a little flat on the free throw.
In close games like this, every point counts.
Without a field goal last 3 or 4 minutes here of game time.
Yeah, the game's got a little sloppy right now. Both teams are not taking care of the basketball. Trudy's got to cash in at the charity stripe, though.
And flat again. Did not look good coming off. And could not cash in, as Eric just said. 3.5 to go, third quarter. Foul that time.
Yep.
As Coy Edwards really good at drawing them.
Yeah, I mean, that's her talent right there. Sequoia Edwards, number one for Palm Beach State. Got Brooklyn Cruz out of space. Got her off her feet. Foul's called. Second personal. Now here's a scenario you want to watch out for, Jeff. You got Taylor Smith and Trudy Walker, the only two sophomores in this squad, both have three personal fouls.
Cruz trying to cause problems. A turnaround here for Garvin. Again, Walker the rebound.
Good rebound. Somebody's got to help her out, come get the basketball set up in space.
Trudy will pull it back out. Bates pushed off. Leave it for Morales.
Wow.
An offensive foul. And the crowd really not enjoying the referee crew right now, making themselves heard.
I mean, I don't see that call right there. Everyone's fighting for space right there. And substitutions. Alexis Jean back in. And Khadijah Huggins comes back in for Palm Beach State.
I have to say, at least questionable at best. Not necessarily bad, but questionable would be the apropos word at the moment.
Well, and obviously, you play in the hometown of the Titans. You know, you can hear the angst of the hometown crew.
They're leaving it all out there, and the crowd's behind them. A lot of energy here, Palm Beach State, and have not been able to convert. Probably need to settle it down a little bit more as we take a look at Smith on the bench.
That's a good news for Caitlin Smith and the Titans to see she's okay. Kind of flashes a mini smile, but you can see we have not had a field goal in a very long time.
Yeah, at least 4 minutes of game time.
We've been stuck at 41-38 as both teams have forgot the basic 1-2-3s of basketball.
1-2-3s in the way of fouls.
Another turnovers. That was a
and
carry.
There's a field goal. for Garvin. Carry or not, Garvin has six. Cruz trying to get up the line, able to do so. Ahead to Bates, will pop the three on the way off the front iron. One and done. Is Garvin playing like a woman possessed right now?
Dangerous spot right now for the
three
Titans.
From three, and Williams brings it up. They're in the lead now, 43-41.
Yeah, dangerous situation right here for the Titans. Brooklyn Cruz has to lead the game. There's a little blood coming off her right elbow.
Ugh.
So she has to check out of the game, and then I'll check in Dora Odia. But right now we were stuck at 41-38 in favor of the Titans for, like you said, a four-minute stretch, and now all of a sudden back-to-back possessions for Palm Beach State.
Yep.
Cruz, nice job for the trainers coming in that gets Cruz back in the game
tonight.
Quickly.
Really busy tonight. They didn't even miss a possession.
Yeah, well, how about that? Dora checks back out.
Eastern Florida going to have to work to get it up the court. Bates moving it quickly. Walker and coming all the way back defensively. Edwards. That's a speedy Noel number right there.
This wouldn't be a bad time to take a timeout. It's been really kind of choppy on possessions offensively. Just to kind of talk to the ladies and get them to say, hey, we're in this game. Take care of the basketball.
Forcing it inside. We'll do it again.
No one's creating any space right here. Down low, you got to set some screens. This is Jim Grimes basketball. He likes to move the basketball. There's got to be movement off the ball.
Morales shot up and good using the glass.
There it is. 9 points for Vic.
Nine, as you just said. And Morales gets the steal.
Look at that.
Take care of it. As Cruz, this time, they will call the foul on Edwards.
They're going to call it on three.
Oh, three instead. So Williams, Shakoya Edwards just doesn't draw fouls.
That's a third personal foul, number three, Crystal Williams. Good look at the truck right there. Look at the defensive play by Morales.
Walker was unmarked on the inbound. She's got the easy layup the other way. Double figures, Trudy.
First points of the second half. Titans needed that from Trudy Walker.
Still down two, 45-43. Long three on the way from Garvin, doesn't go. Not necessarily the best shot selection.
That'll be on the line out of bounds. That should be Titans basketball, and it is. Very fortunate down low, Jeff. Trudy actually knocked off Morales to get the rebound, kind of screened her off. But luckily it was off a Palm Beach State player, Titans basketball.
Smith handled the basketball. Leave it for Morales. 1:12 to go. Morales couldn't get the shot to fall. Walker battling for the rebound. And it's a jump ball.
Jump ball's a call, possession in favor of the Panthers. But I like the effort though. Morales right there, make that extra pass. Taylor or Trudy springs loose for an easy deuce.
Palm Beach State in a tussle here.
Cache Johnson back in, number 23. Crystal Williams picks up that third personal. She'll take a seat for Palm Beach State. But I tell you, this is a bit of a chess match, though. You know, the third quarter's been a little bit choppy, hasn't been a lot of flow, but the bottom line is, each team seems to just find a way and fight back.
This is Jean. Don't want to get her on track. She and Garvin are starting to come alive. The big three are out there. Edwards. Now Huggins. Long three on the way. Off-balance shot doesn't go.
You know, for the Titans, you're okay with that defensively.
Cruz can't keep the handle. Two on one the other way. Behind the back is pretty.
Nice play.
Alexis Jean finishes it off.
Yeah, 8 points, even a better pass. 8 point for Jean.
And ball out of bounds. Eastern Florida will keep it. It's been tough to bring it up the floor against this very athletic team, the Panthers.
But anytime you're breaking that press, you got to create space. You can't let two defenders collapse on you.
45, oh! Eastern Florida in front two, 47-45, 21 ticks left here in the third quarter.
Wow, Trudy Walker with a little Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, a little baby hook.
I love it. Well, we saw Palm Beach play for the last shot at the end of the half.
Yep.
And ring one up. And making the move, Shakora Edwards. And it is up and good at the buzzer again. Jonica Garvin, the Mississippi State signee, gets two more.
Yeah, she picks up her 11th point, and again, two cheap baskets at the end of the second and third quarter. At first, I thought down low defensively, they stopped the basketball. There was no whistle, no foul was called. But again, right there, good heads-up play for number 21, Jonica Garvin, to put that the basket. Got herself a great one, 47 apiece, Jeff.
10 minutes to go, anybody's game, tied at 47.
It's who's going to want it more now? That's the biggest thing. I mean, Trudy, right here, look at this. Look at effort play. You know she wants it right here.
Could be a battle of attrition here. Again, you're just joining us. Caitlin Smith knocked out of the game with an apparent injury. So already short on the bench. Going to have to rely on those sophomores, Trudy Walker and Taylor Smith, I believe.
Well, I'll tell you what, here we go. There's the look right there. Just a good heads-up play, takes it to the glass. Strong move. Now look at Vic Morales. She puts it off, and then Trudy just continues to fight to get that foul. And defensively down low, Trudy Walker, just right there, both sides of the basketball. And look at this little baby hook. Kareem Abdul-Jabbar would be happy. And I'll tell you what, Trudy Walker, the biggest thing about her, her favorite TV show is SpongeBob. We always joke about that off the air. And she says, favorite sport other than the one you're playing is flag football. But this is a good one right here. Plans after completing my education for Trudy Walker, pursuing a professional career in basketball and going into law enforcement. Again, creating a career of giving back to community service.
Well, Trudy has some basketball in front of her as a career. Junior and senior years somewhere.
That's a loose ball foul. Time the foul's in favor of the Titans. Going to be whistling number 21. Jonica Garvin picks up her third personal.
Fouls on Jonica Garvin, her third.
You're hearing Coach Chris Rufo with her opinion.
I tell you, I agree with her, though. There's been some interesting calls.
Oh, shot was flat from Walker.
Interesting calls that either could have gone either way or the whistle could have just not happened.
This is Garvin playing with three fouls. Just underway, thinking about the shot was Gene, and that will be a turnover.
Wow, that's a second errant pass here. Alexis Gene, nobody home.
We talked about motivations here for Palm Beach State College. Had already sewn up the conference championship, a playoff spot. The goose egg is what they were looking for, two games to play to run the conference undefeated. They were able to do that in 2011 and 12, trying to repeat the feat here. And Eastern Florida has other ideas as Trudy Walker gets the put back.
Look at that effort. Trudy Walker wants it more. 14 points for Trudy Walker. Just great hustle right there. She misses a shot, has a heads up play to go up there. And look at that. Look at that, another assistant coach, Matt Provencil, doing what he's got to do for the program. I knew him from UCF basketball, but look at this play. Great job by the truck. She misses her own shot. She wants it more, battles it out, off the glass and in. Trudy Walker's came to play.
Palm Beach down two. And walk with the basketball as Cruz made it difficult. You shall not pass.
Yeah, too many steps there. And Shakoya Edwards needs to be careful right there, the way she bounced the ball back to get a technical foul. Now, what you were talking about before is a great point. Palm Beach State now, you know, saying possibly looking ahead. They've already qualified in advance the NJCAA Region 8 State Championship. Ooh. March 8th through the late in Ocala.
Another foul.
Foul on Shakoya Edwards, her second.
Just her second, which doesn't seem right, but...
Well, the biggest thing is, too, those stoppage of play gets the Titans set. Every possession means so much right now, Jeff.
Walker can't get it to fall. Eastern Florida will keep it. Oh, she wanted that one.
Hey, good heads-up play right there. Just her down there banging bodies. Gets that ball to get a deflection off Palm Beach State. Titans retain possession.
Scrappy Titans. Up by two, Bates the turnaround three on the way. Oh, Morales with the rebound over the back.
Fouls on Cache Johnson.
Cache Johnson whistled for the personal.
Yep, freshman guard out of Chicago, Illinois. First personal foul. Titans will step to the free throw line, two shots.
Morales, 69% free throw shooter. The freshman out of Oviedo played at Hagerty, right down the street from UCF.
She gets into double digits right there. She needs to get to point number 11 here. A couple substitutions here, no correction. They were going to try to bring in Caitlin Smith, but she was brought back quickly, and in her place and back on the floor is Brooklyn Cruz. Caitlin tried to sneak in the game right there.
She wants to be out on the floor to help this team earn a final win here at home, and looks like she's going to be good to go here momentarily.
It looks like Coach Schaefer literally had to walk her down to the end of the bench to see the trainer.
Is he signing a release?
Yeah, she wants it, but
Morales is perfect there.
Yeah, good 2 points right there for Morales at the charity stripe.
She's got 11 points, so she in double figures now. 51-47, lead stretched out to four, and I tell you what, Palm Beach with a lot of dissent as we sit right next to their bench right now and could be coming a little unglued. As Smith comes away, she's running the floor. Taylor Smith has it blocked away by Alexis Jean.
What a great denial by Alexis Jean.
Would have brought the house down, slicing, dicing, scoring, Cachet Johnson.
Wow, that's a 4-point swing right there. Cachet Johnson takes it to the house.
Bates for three is good.
Bates is bringing it. That's her 4th 3-pointer of the game. All her points are from 3-point land. Plus it was timely. Timely 3-pointer for Bates.
Really turn it on here as of late. Mariah Bates, 35% entering the match.
Wow.
3-point land, another rebound.
Shaquoia
5-point lead. Walker cannot get the shot to fall. Smith, the putback is good. Taylor Smith.
Coach Ruffo is out of her mind right now for Palm Beach State Young. She wants to see it call both ways. And a quick basket there for Alexis Jean.
It was the biggest lead of the night for Eastern Florida. Now it's back down to 5.
I think that's a good timeout taken by Eastern Florida right there. You know, to kind of recap and re-summarize everything that's going on, Jeff.
Let's read the body language here of Palm Beach State. They're in a battle here, not a place they're accustomed to being here.
Well, it's a 30-second timeout here. Again, Trudy Walker, just the effort play. Look at Taylor Smith. Both the sophomores coming to play. You got two sophomores you're celebrating tonight. Did back-to-back effort plays and it paid off. Good luck to Coach Schaefer.
Well, looks like Evie Sagner will come in, the 3-point sharpshooter from the outside.
And I'm impressed by that stat you came up to at halftime, is that 9 players eligible to play and all 9 have scored. And that's pretty impressive. Talk about a team effort to get everybody to know their role. But the big thing is, I can tell, as you said, with the body language, Palm Beach State, the defensive effort by the Titans has really frustrated Palm Beach State, because they're usually a wheeling and dealing team. And when it doesn't go for you, you're not used to that.
Tough spot here. As Cruz just saved it. 4-point lead, make that a 5-point lead, 56-51, a kickball. It'll stay with the Titans as we're at 7-11 to go in this fourth quarter. What a performance here, win or lose.
Yep, kickball to reset it to 15 seconds, so actually the Titans get a break there, add 5 seconds because it's already down to 10 to shoot.
And save for Smith and Walker. This is a freshman-dominated team that's sending a message to the rest of the conference for next year, but right now trying to finish off this year. Morales will get another shot at it, and one!
Wow! Morales in an and one. And that's a 3rd personal foul on Shaquoia Edwards. I mean, I really love the energy of Victoria Morales. Great shot there, number 21. And again, another bright spot coming back for next year out of Oviedo, as you mentioned, out of Hagerty. Let's see if she can knock this thing down.
True. 59-51, an 8-point lead, biggest for either team here tonight.
14 points for Morales.
Trying to shoot, Crystal Williams held up, so shoot it again, and they are appealing for a foul. They'll get it from down low, not out 3, as Jean got the and one.
So that'll be a possible N1 situation now for Palm Beach State. Push off, first personal foul. Dia picks up her first personal. It'll be an N1 for Alexis Jean.
Transfer from Kennesaw State, sinks the free throw, 3-point play, 59-54. And here comes a little bit of a half press, getting it out of there.
Get some spacing, that's how you break the press. Good job, Odia, got someone in the wing.
Bates, quick trigger, that one off the mark. One and done, Shakoy Edwards comes out of there. Boy, they press it quickly, nice foul from Bates.
Yep, again, bad offensive set led to that situation for Palm Beach State. You can't allow that to happen, Jeff. Right there, that was not a good shot there for the three-point basket. Palm Beach State likes to run the floor. But a good foul for Bates right there to force him at the free throw line.
15 foul, I believe. No, second. But it's a shooting foul, and it is missed by Johnson, a 50% free throw shooter. So by law of averages, she should make this one here.
Alexis Sparkman back in, number 20. Sophomore to West Palm Beach back in for the Panthers.
A lot of noise on that other side as Johnson does, in fact, make one of two. Cut the lead to four now, 6:32 to play. Here come the reinforcements as Palm Beach using that depth. I'm sure Eastern Florida, not much in the way of legs left.
That ball was tipped out of bounds. Out of bounds. Yeah.
Turned over.
Again, just can't get that ball inbounds. Again, that's the only time Titans have stubbed their toe. And again, the ball was kind of tipped out of bounds. I don't think she really saw that. If she let the ball go out of bounds, it would have stayed with the Titans. But she didn't know that. She went to the floor, hits the baseline, out of bounds, Panthers.
And Edwards will have been the catalyst. And now Jean can't get it to go. We'll have a second opportunity. They work it around. Garvin puts it on the floor. Now out to Sparkman. What do we got?
They're going to say it's a reset shot clock. No basket. They're going to reset it to 25 seconds, so it'll stay with the Panthers. At first, I thought they were going to call a three-second violation down low, but they call it reset the shot clock.
Alexis Sparkman. Four three-pointers against Eastern Florida in that first meeting. Shakoy Edwards barks things out, getting the low entry ball. And the putback somehow comes out of the cylinder. Jonica Garvin couldn't get it to go. Odia will turn around, face the basket, put it up. Garvin blocks it out of bounds.
You know, Odia had a chance there, though. Trudy Walker was on the backside of the defense. One more pass, Trudy would have an up and easy in off the basket.
The easiest baskets possible here.
Yeah.
The lead is four. Bates thought about the three. We'll kick it out. Odia will drive again. Baseline, Jay on the way. Bunny, Victoria Morales.
16 points, a big time bucket for Morales.
Trying to counter on the other end as Jean couldn't get it to go. Cruz in some trouble.
The press is really giving trouble to Titans right now.
Odia walked with the basketball.
Travels with the basketball. Again, this press is really forcing some issues on the Titans. Just got to slow it down. Slow it down. Get set. Somebody's got to come get the basketball.
Luckily for Eastern Florida, it's been an off night for Palm Beach State shooting.
Great
46.9 from the field. That's good for fifth in the nation. They've not been near that tonight. Don't have the official number. We don't have the stat. But
just got to protect the rim here. I don't see that right there.
Bailed out.
Yep, that was a bailout foul.
Bates, I believe, picked it up.
Yeah, it's her second personal.
Shakes her head, disagreeing. Edwards will inbound the basketball for Palm Beach State. Trailed by six here with five to play.
Taylor Smith checks in down low for the Titans. And they're gonna call a hold down low. Yeah, and she comes Smith in, picks up her fourth personal just like that. She's in, the clock doesn't even run. She picks up her fourth personal foul. You gotta have more heads up. You come in with three, gotta protect those fouls.
Florida just trying to deny anything. Garvin, nice turnaround again, doesn't go. Rebound, Edwards, smallest player on the floor. Garvin, second shot, no. Again, Edwards comes out, flops to the floor, and turns it over.
Very lucky for the Titans right there. Number 22 of your Titans, Brooklyn Cruz. She led inside position for the Panthers to get two looks at it. Got to close out the space and block out.
Morales, under five to go. Here's Cruz. She'll pull up from about 16 and drain it. Brooklyn Cruz. Boy, they need her to get hot right now.
I bet you she heard me call her out on defense right there. She makes it out. Big bucket for Brooklyn Cruz and the Titans.
63-55, an 8-point lead. A defensive stop would be great here. Long ball, and that shot was forced a bit by Jean.
Nice pull down board by Mariah Bates.
Bates thought about it.
This is when you gotta start working the time. You gotta reverse the ball, get some ball movement, get a nice set.
15 on the shot clock for Eastern Florida. Cruz now into Walker. Oh. Boy, in and out of the cylinder.
That was a good look. But one more pass kick to Morales. She's got a wide open shot for the three.
Panthers need a bucket. Entry ball, tough to handle. Quick turnaround, no foul. Walker the rebound.
What great defense. Trudy Walker stands her ground.
Another personal there on Edwards. Fourth personal.
Yeah, that's four fouls. That's a big foul right there, especially when you're in the trail position by 8 points. She's the ringleader of Palm Beach State. She's the catalyst for the Panthers.
15 foul, that means free throws on the other end. Here's where Brooklyn Cruz can make it happen.
Yeah, you gotta score some points when the clock is down. Good rotation.
Nothing but net.
Couple subs in for the Panthers, brings back Crystal Williams. She's got three personal fouls, and Cashay Johnson checks in, number 23. Great opportunity here, Jeff, to make this a double-digit lead in terms of favor of the, for the Titans.
As a 10-point lead.
How about that?
Cruz, ice in the veins from the foul line.
And I like the way she's made of amends of a couple rebounds that she could have blocked out. So good job, Brooklyn Cruz, fighting back.
Defensive effort, and again, Palm Beach State coming unglued, not used to this kind of battle. And they won by 9 earlier this season on their home floor against Eastern Florida.
Yeah, actually, Eastern Florida Titans played them very strong down south. And again, a lot of time to play, but boy, this would be a great win for this program with everything that's happened to it.
Bates pulls up and scores it. Bates.
Wow. That's her first two-point bucket. How about that?
A lot of confidence here for Eastern Florida. They are up 12 on the conference champs here.
Now get back to what you know and what's kept you in this game to get in the lead. Play defense. Force every play. Get them frustrated.
Huggins, she'll pull up from about the same spot as Bates. And again, Walker cleaning up the board. Lead is 12. Cruz, Smith, down low, up, and could not get it to go down.
Wow. And N1 could have been a dagger.
What's called on the mind 10. Of Chris Rufo right now? He came into this game needing just to win the last two to finish off a perfect season. They have gotten an inspired performance from Eastern Florida here tonight.
Huggins picks up her first personal, so that'll send sophomore Taylor Smith to line with two shots.
Smith makes the first, and the lead continues to grow. It is 13, just under 3 to go.
I'm just so happy with the effort right now, both the sophomores, that they're going to celebrate after the game. Really bringing that energy tonight, leaving it all on the court.
Could not get the second.
Got to play defense here. This game is not over. Palm Beach State can score in bunches.
Yeah, you're right. Garvin, the best players on this team, will take it. Scoop shot. Walker the rebound, says that is mine. Clearing people out. Little cheap shot on the other end as Johnson got into the back of her.
Great Cruz. Aggressive rebound by Trudy.
Bates working that clock. No. And the shot doesn't go. Smith comes away with the rebound. Back out to Walker. Will put up the shot, blocked. by Gene. Gene puts the shot up and one. Or is it
no,
a charge?
It's a charge, going the other way. That's her fourth personal foul. It'll negate the basket. That's a big defensive play against defense. Who wants it more? We talked about it earlier.
Let's think of the other end here now. Don't need to really force up a shot. Use the clock here.
Ball movement. Coach Grimes, wherever he is, talking from us from above.
2 minutes.
Move that basketball
point,
for Coach
make
Grimes.
Make them foul. You're in the bonus. And now wrestled away. Edwards will try to lay it up. Blocked by Morales and not in my house.
What a denial by Morales.
Cruz, not going to be easy tonight. 68-55, we'll use the clock. Looking for the steal on Cruz. The entry ball into Smith. We'll put the shot up, denied.
Knocked out of bounds. But
here comes
Odia. I just love the energy and the effort right now. I mean, if they can hold this off, this is a big time win. I mean, and a great timeout by Eastern Florida. Full timeout called on the floor. And just kind of reset it. You know, $1.35, Jeff left. You know what I mean? You got to close the deal here. Look at this. Look at the effort play here.
A great steal there, but then not giving up.
I mean, what a great denial by Morales. Morales, what a great game. She's got 16 points, but the things on the stat sheet, just defensively, to go down there. And again, it was a no call at midcourt. Good steal by Shakoya Edwards, to take it down. Brooklyn Cruz was upset there was no call, but Vic doesn't give up on the play. She goes down there and bangs it off the board. So impressed by the effort for the Titans. Being the last home game and seeing these two sophomores of Trudy Walker and Taylor Smith, and I just, you know, getting to know Trudy on the show, Jeff, it's just, I know what they've gone through from a program and everybody involved with the Titans family, and, you know, losing a coach and a good guy, a family guy like that, thoughts and prayers go out to the Grimes family, is that, boy, this would taste really, really good.
Right now. What an effort this has been. You know, Palm Beach thought they were going to roll over, and it has not happened.
Tell you what, in real estate business I've been doing for a long time, doesn't happen. You can write the deal, you got to close the deal.
That's right. You got to get to closing.
Got to close
Sometimes
it right
you
here.
You got to wait 30 days, but hey.
Yep.
Cruz, Bates will hold on to it. 90 seconds to go. And some trouble. Cruz. And that will be the fifth foul, I believe, on Edwards. Going for the steal. Boy,
that's
she's an impressive specimen, though. She has been a really feisty player tonight, and Edwards will foul out. What a player. She will move on next year for sure. Somebody will be very happy to get her.
Boy, Shakoya Edwards right there.
And you got one of the big three out of the game. And now Cruz, who has been nails at the free throw line here. And continues to be so.
Brooklyn Cruz, good rotation on the free throws.
Commentator's curse. She's got 11 points.
Great game by Brooklyn Cruz.
69-55. Garvin, go to the go-to, gets the shot to fall.
Yep. They got the players. There's no doubt they can go deep.
Going for the steal. Walker's got it.
In the postseason for Palm Beach State, but it's tonight, it's Titans.
Pull it back out, 69-57, 12-point lead. Just need to take care of the basketball here. It will be the win of the season, a reach-in foul for Cache Johnson.
Under a minute to play, and the foul on the floor is going to be called to number 23. She picks up her second personal foul, and again, Brooklyn Cruz. It is amazing with broadcasts, as many games you've announced, and I've been around in certain circles. It is amazing sometimes that that broadcasting jinx does hit home.
It does. Sometimes we're fortunate enough to see a performance like this, though. It makes it all worthwhile, right?
I tell you what, Brooklyn Cruz comes in and 16 points, career high last game, now already has 12.
Could be 13 here, and we'll extend this lead out. And does just that.
You did the anti-jinx there. Well done, Ms. Radcliffe.
14-point advantage. Long three on the way is good for Gene.
Yep. 16 points for that young lady.
Timeout. Eastern Florida as it got that much more tight. It's an 11-point advantage. Very important to be disciplined here and take care of the basketball on this inbound.
Good set there by Alexis Jean. That's why they're known as the Big Three. You got Shakoy Edwards just fouled out. Alexis Jean, their leading scorer, and Jonica Garvin. But I tell you what, it's been the recurring theme for me is that tonight you could see this way this game unfolded, Jeff, is that defensive effort was going to dictate the way this game came out. And there was a lot of sloppy times that you thought the way the Titans weren't taking care of the basketball, that you thought the Palm Beach State was going to, you know, they hit that shot at the end of the first half, that was going to be like, that was their wake-up call. And for the Titans to get through that third quarter sluggish area and to hold that off and to build a double-digit lead, wow, something special is going on here today.
All the adjectives apply. Scrappy, stuck in, tough. That's what Eastern Florida's been. They have really been grinders tonight.
Now, that's going to be a long 46.3 seconds, I can tell you that.
I agree. In the hands of Cruz. Remember, Caitlin Smith went out of the game middle of this second half with an injury.
Yep.
And Cruz has had been handling things.
I'll tell you
33
what.
Seconds, they'll hold the basketball here.
Coach Rufo is saying no foul.
Going to let this victory play out. 24 seconds. Clock down to 6. Walker, the sophomore, putting it up. Smith back up and good! As the shot clock expires, Taylor Smith.
Sophomore magic. It's the Trudy Walker and Taylor Smith show.
8 seconds left as Huggins gets 2 more. It is going to be a Titan winner tonight. As time expires, 73-62. An 11-point win on sophomore night. Trudy Walker and Taylor Smith embrace. There will be no undefeated season in Palm Beach this year. The win for the ages tonight.
73-62, unbelievable. What a win, what a gritty effort. As you mentioned, just all the superlatives you could talk about. And let's take a look back. This was a special evening. Let's take it away.
Boy, the heart of a Titan not being denied here as we look at some of the highlights.
I mean, just great effort play. That extra pass I talked about. Bates is in the corner, wide open, squares. You can see she's got the look. She knows she's going to drain it. Again, look at that pass. Nice screen down low. Trudy Walker clears it out. Another 3-point basket. Inbounds play, Brooklyn Cruz. And Morales, I tell you, unsung hero. Morales comes in 16 points, Jeff, and Trudy Walker. She wants it tonight. Takes it to the house with a kiss and the glass. And Trudy Walker, nice little jump baby hook. I mean, just this team tonight for Jim Grimes to beat Palm Beach State, coming in at 21-2, undefeated in conference, and to beat them tonight like this in double digits is something else. And right here, I love the way they made that extra pass. When they made that extra pass, Bates was open. And look at Morales. Gets her own rebound and one. Victoria Morales. And look at Odia. She makes the extra pass. Morales squares up her shoulders. Another drain from the baseline. On and on it goes. And look at Brooklyn Cruz. Welcome back, Brooklyn Cruz. Future is bright. And here we go. Look at his shot. Comes up with the energy and just trains it. Nothing but net. Great. Great win for the Titans.
It is indeed that. 73-62, the heart of a Titan on display tonight. You can call it a win for the ages as well. What it does is it gives the Titans their 10th win of the season, double-digit wins after where they were at a certain point. Now joined by Stephanie Schaefer. My goodness, what a performance. Thank you very much for giving us that here on WEFS.
Yeah.
What does it feel like? And to have those sophomores go out with such a big game.
Oh, I'm so happy. I'm so excited for the sophomores. You know, this one's really special. Coach Grimes, that was his last game against Palm Beach, and he told us how much we could go get him next time. And so this was special. I had all the girls stepped up for the sophomores. We talked about playing for Coach, playing for them, playing for each other, and I just saw all the Titan Four on display tonight.
Coach Grimes said, go get him next time.
Yep.
You did get after them.
It
was a scrappy affair.
It was.
Heart-filled affair. not pretty at times.
No.
But you found a way to win. Talk about just the all-out effort from really everybody up and down that roster.
Yeah, there was a all-out effort by everyone, and I was just so impressed by the guard play as well. I know Caitlin Smith, she's an excellent ball handler for us, and so to see her injured in the third quarter, yeah, that was that could have been something, adversity that we, you know, took a step back from, but instead we leaned into it, and we the guards stepped up and did great. And I can't say enough about the performance of both of our sophomores tonight, Taylor and Trudy. I thought they played excellent, and I was just so proud of the effort of everyone.
Talk about the aspect of getting a 10th win, excuse me, in double digits, but now a chance to go on the road at ASA and finish even in conference play, and maybe outside chance extend the season right now. I mean, this win is huge in so many aspects.
It's huge. I think it what it says is, hey, the Titans are here to play, and I would love an extra chance for more ball if the opportunity presents itself, but I'm proud because the girls are really clicking and gelling and buying into the principles that coach has preached from day one, but we've struggled to execute for 40 minutes, and you saw that 40 minutes of scrappy principle execution ball tonight.
Eric and I were chatting about, you're giving a preview of the rest of the conference next year, all these freshmen that are returning.
Mm-hmm.
This is going to be a force to contend with next year, but you still got games here this year, too.
Yep, it's very exciting. You know, we're watching the freshmen grow up before our very eyes.
Yes, they're sophomores now, aren't they?
Yep, they are. And I think that really happened during the Miami-Dade game. I think I really saw the freshmen step up and be sophomores at the Miami-Dade game.
Last thing before we let you go, it is sophomore night.
Yep.
Talk about what Trudy Walker has meant to this program over 2 years, and then Taylor Smith coming in as a transfer. What a performance tonight, but man, they true exemplify what it means to be a Titan.
Yeah, I mean, Trudy has just been the heart and soul of our basketball team this year. You know, we call 24 high. That's an isolation play for her, and she screams, "Give me the ball!" And I think to myself, if I'm playing with her, give her the ball. You know, and she full effort. She's been a great voice for us, especially since Coach Grimes passed away. He was the loudest voice in the room, and I feel like Trudy's really stepped up in leadership ways. And Taylor, she was such a great addition to our program this year. And I know the day she signed with us, Coach Grimes looked at me and said, "We got better today." And so we're just grateful to have her.
Amen to that. Well, congratulations. A very big win against the conference champs, 73-62, the final score. I'll let you get to the sophomore ceremony.
Okay.
Recognize Trudy and Taylor. Congratulations.
Thank
what
you so
a
much.
Joy to watch.
It was fun.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
That is Stephanie Schaefer, one of the interim head coaches for Eastern Florida State College. Boy, what a performance tonight. We will take in now an added bonus this sophomore night. The two sophomores for Eastern Florida be recognized here as Coach Schaefer trying to join the party. Again, getting the big win here on the home finale as Eric Kohler rejoins. Just truly blessed to be able to witness what we saw here tonight.
And now we're going to get started with the sophomore class. Up first,
we'll join now the sophomore ceremony right here at the Titan Fieldhouse.
Average 14 points. She had 10 plus rebounds in 3 of the past 5 games and scored at least 10 points in the last 7 games. Our other sophomore is number 24, Trudy Walker. Trudy has 15 double-doubles, actually 16 double-doubles for the number one tonight. She's also got 20-plus rebounds in 2 of the last 3 games for the Titans. Thank you.
sophomores would like to say a quick word about Trudy and Taylor. First up is Caitlin Smith with a few kind words. Taylor Smith. Go Taylor. Where do I even begin? I've known you for over 10 years. It seems like it's been better since I can't even remember. The thing that all our members have in common is that they all involve one thing, basketball. We started out as local first timers on a local AAU team. Then we played middle school, high school, and who would thought college basketball together. When you first told me that you're leaving Kennesaw, I couldn't call Coach Brown fast enough. We have to get Taylor, Coach. We have to. Then you were here, and even better, my roommate. This past year has brought us much closer than before. We had to share a room and bathroom together, a first experience for us both. We had our fair share of arguments and laughs, but we managed to get through. We continue to make new memories every day, basketball-related as well as outside of basketball. Though the season did turn out how we both expected or planned, I couldn't be any happier that I got to play college basketball with my big sister and my forever teammate. I love you, Taylor.
To this program, Eric Kohler, what a wonderful night we just witnessed.
Well, what a special win, man. 73-62 to beat Palm Beach State. They came in sizzling hot, hadn't lost till December. But for Coach Jim Grimes and his family, and a testament to this team and the program, this is pretty special, Jeff. It was great working with you. Big win for the Titans.
Likewise. And Coach Grimes, we miss you. But your Titans did you proud tonight, 73-62. For Eric Kohler, our producer, Laritz Kirolf, our director, Paul Mitten, our entire WEFS crew, I'm Jeff Radcliffe saying so long.